Hello students, today we are going to do the chapter 5a, only Avogadro's law. Remaining part of the chapter 5a has already been completed in the class. These three balloons in the corner, you can see, these balloons have the same volume. Avogadro states that these balloons will contain the same number of molecules. Now what is this law? He forwarded this law in 1811. He stated the hypothesis, which states the relationship between the number of molecules in equal volumes of different gases under similar condition. This is very important word. So what is the law statement? Equal volumes of all gases under similar condition of temperature and pressure contain the same number of molecules. What does it mean? If you have 1 liter of hydrogen, 1 liter of chlorine, oxygen or any other gas, under similar condition, they all will contain the same number of molecules. Like if you have 1 liter of hydrogen which contains X molecules, then if you have 1 liter of oxygen, chlorine, nitrogen, methane, whatever, any gas, they also will contain X molecules under similar conditions of temperature and pressure. You learn the definitions of atoms, molecules, atomicity. Now, homoatomic and heteroatomic. Homoatomic molecules are the molecules which are made up of same types of atoms. Examples are given. Heteroatomic molecules are made up of different types of atoms. Now, what are the applications of Avogadro's law? You determine the atomicity of the gases. You explain the Grignard's law. Relate the gram molecular mass and gram molar volume of the gas. To relate molecular mass and vapor density, to determine the molecular formula of a gas. These three, last three points will be done in 5C. So, explanation of Gay-Lussac's law by Avogadro's law. You first read these two laws which we have already done. Now, what is happening? Here you can see two volume of hydrogen reacts with one volume of oxygen to give two volume of water. Here we have considered water. Example, water is considered as a gas, that is, it's in the vapor condition or steam condition. So, it is by Gay-Lussac's law. If you consider Avogadro's law, you will find it is 2n molecules of hydrogen, n molecules of oxygen, 2n molecules of water. Because you can see oxygen 1 volume, if contains n molecules, then hydrogen 2 volume will contain 2n molecules. And similar for now, how Avogadro's law helped you to find the atomicity? Now, consider this equation. Again, the same thing. All are gases. So, by Gay-Lussac's law, you have one volume of hydrogen reacts with one volume of chlorine to give two volume of hydrogen chloride. So, here you are having n molecules of hydrogen reacts with n molecules of chlorine gives you 2n molecules of HCl. One volume, two volume, n molecules and 2n molecules. So, one molecule of hydrogen reacts with one molecule of chlorine gives you two molecules of HCl. So, half molecule of hydrogen and half molecule of chlorine will give you one molecule of HCl. Now, we know that atoms are indivisible. So, half molecule must contain at least one atom each of hydrogen and chlorine. So consequently, one molecule of each of hydrogen and chlorine contains two atoms each. Now, how do you go for the molecular weight of gaseous compound? If you go for the molecular formula, so this is the chemical formula which gives the actual number of atoms of the elements present in one molecule of a compound. Consider this example. 2 volume of ammonia on decomposition gives you 1 volume of nitrogen and 3 volumes of hydrogen. It is by experiment. If you consider Avogadro's law, you will find 2 molecules of ammonia reacts with 1 molecule of two molecules of ammonia gives you one molecule of nitrogen and three molecules of hydrogen. So similarly, you break those one molecule, you know nitrogen is diatomic, hydrogen is diatomic. So we get two atoms of nitrogen and six atoms of hydrogen. Divide by two, you'll get one molecule contains one atom of nitrogen and three atoms of hydrogen. So one molecule of ammonia contains one atom of nitrogen, three atoms of hydrogen gas. So you go through your page 16 of your book, question number 19. There you will be finding, this is under Avogadro's law, the answers given, more volumes will contain more molecules and least will contain less. So 5 liters of hydrogen will contain the greatest number of molecules and 1 liter of SO2 contain the least. Go to problem 20, you will be seeing that 20 liters of nitrogen contains X molecules. It is given. So 10 liter will contain half. Again, 20 liter of ammonia will contain X. And 5 liter of sulfur dioxide will contain X by 4. So the Avogadro law again is applied over here. Same for problem 21. 150 cc of gas A contains X molecules. So 75 cc contains half X molecules. Again, this is Avogadro's law. So you complete all the problems of chapter 5A as discussed in the class. Next session will be on the chapter 5B. You note down all your doubts in your copy and we'll discuss as soon as the class resumes. You stay safe and healthy at your home.